Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna continue working on part 15 of this LC house. Let's get started. So in the last video, we already started painting the house. So we're setting up different materials, but we want it to be consistent. And then we're modeling it to this one. So now we're going to continue working on it on the outside because we don't want to miss add anything. So here I'm going to copy this again because I'm planning to finish off this design onto the back. So now let's go to north elevation, and then let's go and do the model in place. And then we're going to do extrusion. We're going to pick the plane, select the plane right there, and then it's already selected the material, so it's basically being consistent with what we're doing. 200 as well, and then 200 at the top. And then now we need to just trim and extend, and then just delete the excess. Click on finish, and then look at it at 3D first. Let's align it right here to align everything. And before we click on finish here, we need to use paint to add the wood finish. So type in wood, and I believe we have the wood right here, because that's the material that we use for the top right here. And then now we need to click on finish because we need to set the same material right here for the outside. So now what we need to do is select modify and then paint, because the model in place is different from what we have right here on the regular. So you need to know that, and you need to be consistent regarding that. And then here we need to add the metal finish as well, right about here at the top. I just noticed that we didn't do it right here, so it's a good way of just we need to add that below there to be consistent on all of them except for the one below there. So we might do that later on. So this one we could just unhide and then go back to north elevation and then do it all over again. Model in place, generic, pick a plane, this one, 200 right here, 200 right there, trim and extend, and then metal sheeting, go to 3D. To extend it by using align, and then now click on. Before you click that, go to paint, type in wood, and then add that finish right there at the top. And then now let's add the paint right here, which is the metal sheeting. And then now to be consistent again, we need to do the section box, and then from below put it up, and then we could just select this one, to be change. Obviously, we don't need a lot. Click on finish. Select this one and select that. And we just want to be consistent with finishes. So that's good. And then lastly, this part. For this part, it just needs to be that part right there. So now click on this one, use this for your reference, and then make sure this is 90 degrees. And then now click on paint, click on apply there. Done. So that looks good. Next thing we're gonna do is just uncheck section box right now, and then add the proper ones for all the outside, because we're gonna make everything inside white, but from the outside we want it to be different. Also, here on the border wall, what did we use? A border wall finish. I will also select this one. We need to change this one right here so that to be consistent as well. Click finish. And then I'm going to change how it is right here. I just deleted the splitting element, how it splits, so that this one can be changed. Then now connect it there, and to see it right here, now I just need to just add one to be everything like that, and then select border wall. So whatever finish that we have right here will be just on this part. And then everything else will be added. The only problem is this one is overlapping. So I'm just gonna undo this. I think we should just leave how it is. And then do it one by one. And then this one as well. So that we could just I think this one's good enough, actually. So that's good. So now we're setting this up already. And then everything else, I'll probably do the same thing right here. Splitting this face. And then right here as well, this piece, because it's its own face. And then select this one, border wall, select that, and then select that. So now we're just adding a different finish now all throughout, and then maybe the one in the front is by itself as well. So I'm just thinking out of the box. So now paint, we're gonna do an unused one. Probably I'm gonna select paper for this one in front. So that's paper now. So I'll just maybe masonry to make it look different. Okay, I'll do use paper for here and then masonry everywhere so that we could see the difference, and then we could say that something is not correct. So now here, there. Because we did it correctly, it's working like that. And that's how easy it is to do paint. Setting up finishes. Then here we have one piece right here that we just need to add. I'm just double checking now if we saw here and there. We need to fix this. I'll probably add the same finish just to showcase that. And then this one as well, you need to put in a different finish. I forgot this finish, but I remember it's something stone, so stone 2. I need to add a stone 2 there, so we need to section box this. So here we need to change this finish right here. So this is stone 2, and then this one as well. Let's not forget this. Click on finish, and then this one should be the one that we're using right now, but let's put in stone 2. There we go. And then the other one is I believe masonry, this one. So now everything is consistent. Let's double check right here. Everything is painted, and I'm happy with what we have here. We just need to fix the railing for the second floor. Railing right here at the back. Edit path, delete this, and then just pull it right there. And then this one. And delete this. That looks really nice. I'm still thinking of what kind of panel I'm gonna use here. And then undo this one right here. And then just put masonry. There we go. I'm gonna add in a roof right here. So second floor, add the roof. I'm just gonna leave it like that. And then use AL. I think that's good enough. And then we're probably base offset this to negative 400. So probably more negative 1000. Negative 1400. So that's good enough. And then add in asphalt single shingles. And then right here, asphalt singles. The top right here. So that looks good. And then let's just add the same finish around all the edges right here. So masonry, because as you remember, we need to go on each and every window. I can see what I'm highlighting, that's why I was able to do this easily. But what you can do is do the same thing regarding the sectioning. So in order for you to do this, use section box as well if you're having a hard time. But I was able to use capitalize by using just tab, and then I could see the highlighted part. Most of the time, just hover over to the nearest or what you're wanted to do, and then click on tab. That's how easy it is to control that. And then here as well, of course, sometimes it's actually very anal, or it's hard to do, but you have to do what you have to do. So you could do section if you want, you could do section box if you want to as well, just to change everything. And then I believe I've finished those. I'm just surprised that I didn't do anything regarding here, even for a window. So maybe I should just add a window right here. So I'm gonna add a window. So by using curtain wall, and then cut geometry. Let's go to 3D. And then use cut geometry. It's just weird that it got put right there, but once you get the grab on it, just quickly add something right there. And I'm just gonna add in the mullion, something like that, quickly. And then maybe I'm going to change the material. So I'm gonna paint this one. So I'm gonna use one of the unused. Then just click on concrete that. Same time over the window. And I'm good with that. Just double check everything, making sure that everything is 100%. But this masonry, I'm probably gonna use metal panelings instead, because it looks really nice on a modern house with a bunch of wood materials and all those kind of stuff. So it really gives out a modern house look. So let's stop here for now and continue in the next video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you liked the video. Please hit like and subscribe. Feel free to comment down below.